chapter number 10 from verse number 4. And I shall read as well from the book of Ephesians chapter number 6 from verse number 10. I will read. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God. I want you to understand that. The weapons of our warfare. In other words, the Bible is saying the warfare is there. There are some people who say, as long as I'm now in Christ, I'm no longer going to face any battle. That's a lie from the devil. The warfare are there. But the Bible is saying, our weapon, therefore, they are not carnal, but they are mighty in God for pulling down every stronghold, casting down argument, and everything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. I will go and read from the book of Ephesians, chapter number 6, from verse number 10. I'll start from verse number 11. The Bible says, put on the full armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. The Bible is saying, put on the full armor of God. In other words, it's giving us warnings as the children of God that we are going to face warfare. We are going to face battles. But the Bible is saying, put the full armor of God. In other words, it's giving us, it's equipping us that now that you are a child of God, you are no longer going to fight against the flesh and the blood. A teacher with panam, a teacher with rope, a teacher with physical. But the Bible is saying we are now going to have the warfare that are spiritual. And the Bible says we are fighting against spiritual of darkness, principalities, powers. Those are our battles. And the Bible is saying, put on the full armor of God that you may be able to stand. And some is saying, prophetess, what are you saying? I'm saying, my brother, my sister, battles are there. If you are in Christ, it doesn't mean you must fold your hands. It doesn't mean you must slumber. You must sleep. You must be awake. You must be alert. You must be in the battlefield each and every time, fighting for your children, fighting for your marriage, for your company, fighting for your destiny. And the Bible say there are weapons that you are to use in that battlefield. That weapons are now different. If you go to the book of 1 Samuel, it speaks of the weapons that natural people, the people of this world uses. You look at the weapons that Goliath had, and versus the weapons that David had. The Bible say Goliath, he came with the javelins, he came with the spears, but David said, no, now that I'm now in Christ, these are not the type of weapons that I use. They are better weapons that God has given me. I'm here to give you some of the weapons that you need when you are in the battlefield, in the spiritual battlefield. Maybe you're praying for your marriage. You are not going to use physical, that are physical weapons, but you need spiritual weapons. And the first weapon that I need you to have in your battlefield is the weapon of the word of God. My friend, you cannot fight the devil without the word of God. Remember, he was with God. Remember, he was the archangel of God. Remember, he was the worshiper. He knows the word of God. When he tempted Jesus, he tempted him with scriptures. So you cannot enter in the battlefield without the full of the word of God. Before what then Satan who said to our pingam hondonai, are you full of the word of God? You must ask yourself, at the pingam prayer not our nyambu. When you enter in the warfare with the devil, you declare and you manifest the power of the word of God. And another weapon that I want you to take note of is the weapon of faith. Some they pray, but they pray without faith. Some they declare without faith. They enter in the battlefield without even having faith that they are conquerors. They have already won at the cross of Calvary. Do you believe? Do you have faith in your Lord Jesus? Do you have faith in this shield? Do you have your faith in this Lord that you have received as your Lord and Savior? The Bible speaks of the generals in the book of Hebrews chapter number 11. Those who conquered by faith. The Bible says without faith it is impossible to please God. Do you have faith that you can buy that house before you start to pray for the house? Do you have faith that you can have that million before you pray for that million? Do you have faith that you are an heir to the throne? You are the possessor of your father's inheritance. Do you have faith? Another weapon that I want to give
your salvation. Was that you up in your prayer? Come on, come on, Jesus. Do you know him as your father? Do you know him as your Lord and Savior? Some they just enter in prayer, yet they don't have the relationship with their God. Bible says when Jesus was teaching his disciples to pray, he said, when you are praying, call him your father, our father who art in heaven. You cannot call him your father if you haven't received him. That's another weapon. And another weapon that I can touch, and there are so many weapons from the book of Ephesians, but let me speak another weapon again. It's the weapon of prayer. My God, you need to enter in prayer. How am I going to show, to throw my word in prayer, to show my faith in prayer, to show that he is my father, I speak with him every day? You need the weapon of prayer as a child of God. They are not carnal, they are mighty in Christ Jesus. My friend, my brother, Zimbabwe, Africa, brethren, you need these weapons as you are fighting for your marriage, as you are fighting for your nation, as you are fighting this coronavirus, as you are fighting the challenges that you may face in our nation. We need these weapons. And David said, you have javelins, but I have the Lord. I have faith. I have the blood of Jesus. I have received him. I know him. I fellowship with him. I have this helmet of salvation. I have this belt of the truth, the breastplate of righteousness. What weapon do you have before you enter into the battlefield with the devil? God bless you, Prophetess Memory Matibire from Daughters of Virtue, Ndatini wa Prayer Group. Amen.